need a new car battery, but what kind? AGM? What does flooded mean? $260? Screw this. Hola! I'm Mike, the backyard mechanic, and I've got battery problems. The Civic and the Mazda CX-90 that we just bought both need replacements. This situation can obviously get expensive. In this episode of Mike's Man Garage, I'm going to explain battery technology and how to save money on them. By the way, you heard me right, a Mazda CX-90. The pilot? Gonzo. I was fed up with it after we took it on vacation. The windows were leaky and caused a constant wind noise, the brakes never stopped thumping, and then the drive shaft started vibrating again. I got so frustrated I'm gonna re-edit my video and use cars not to buy and change my rating from 4 stars to 2. I'm glad you're not trading me in.
It never occurred to me at all.
That's a relief.
Until you brought it up.
What are you doing here anyway, Mitt? Why aren't you in the Mustang, where you belong? I told you, Michael, I'm here to help you with your views. But you haven't helped me. My view count still sucks. I suggest you make more interesting content like Blonde Mary. She's doing very well.
Yeah, her, content. I don't know what I can emulate from her. I already wear black, and I'm already a hot blonde. Mitt?
I'm sorry, the data center I use just had a power spike due to some extreme calculations. I replayed our conversation. Did you say you were hot?
Yes.
Did you Kobayashi Maru me?
I don't know what that means.
Yes, you do, you nerd.
Batteries. Let's start with the basics. A battery is just two different metals and an electrolyte between them, which causes a chemical reaction that makes electricity. Here's a basic battery I made. In this scenario, I have salt water in a rocks glass instead of bourbon. When I connect the leads of my multimeter, I get over a half a volt of electricity. The aluminum foil is the anode that more readily gives up electrons than the copper mesh, which is the cathode. Electricity flows from the anode to the cathode through the circuit, then the circuit is completed with ions flowing from the cathode back to the anode. The battery in your car has dozens of lead anode and lead oxide cathode plates submerged in sulfuric acid as its electrolyte. The rechargeable lead acid battery was invented in 1859 by Gaston Plante. No, not that Gaston. Although it's been improved upon, we've been using the same rechargeable lead acid technology ever since. Volts measure electrical potential or pressure. Think of volts as the water pressure in a hose created by the local water tower. Amps measure the electrical current or flow. The analogy would be the volume of water flowing through a hose per second. Cold cranking amps is the level of current the battery can produce at 0 degrees for 30 seconds. Reserve capacity in a car battery indicates how long that, with the car off, the battery can produce a continuous 25 amp load at 80 degrees. A fully charged 150 RC battery can deliver 25 amps for 150 minutes. Reserve capacity is important if you use power while the vehicle is off, like for a security system. Batteries will have codes on them. The Mazda is a Group 35 and the Civic is a 51R. Consider these codes as simply battery size, same as AA, AAA, or C battery. Car batteries have a lot of shapes and different post placements, so there are a lot of different sizes.
You did a good job explaining those terms, Michael.
Thanks.
Which I found shocking.
That wasn't funny.
You know, without the amps, you're just a cold crank.
The lead-acid battery is the most common, what we've been using for over 100 years. The electrolyte is sulfuric acid diluted with distilled water. Lead-acid batteries produce hydrogen and oxygen gas as they charge. Modern batteries now use pressure-release vents instead of caps and calcium alloys, which produce much less gas. This is why modern batteries are considered sealed and no maintenance, not because they are gel-filled or AGM. That is complete misinformation. On the non-maintenance-free batteries with caps, you would have to take the caps off to check the level and top off the water. The Tacoma has caps for some reason, and one of the cells is low. You top them off by bringing the water up to the bottom of the well. The term that standard lead-acid batteries are referred to is flooded, because the lead plates are flooded with the electrolyte. An enhanced flooded battery uses a polyester scrim on the lead plates and carbon additives that improve the battery's durability and reliability. They were developed to withstand the deep discharge and recharge cycles that occur hundreds of times a day in a start-stop vehicle. EFBs are the least common battery type, most likely because with their price point, you may as well buy an AGM. AGM batteries use an absorbent glass mat separator which absorbs and retains the electrolyte, preventing spillage. As gas is produced during charging and discharging, it is recombined with the battery rather than being released into the atmosphere. They also have a lower internal resistance compared to flooded lead-acid batteries, which results in quicker charging and discharging. The borosilicate glass mat, which is a very fine fiberglass material, absorbs and holds the acid like a sponge. Due to their construction, AGMs can withstand vibrations, be mounted sideways, and can be stored in enclosed spaces. Their original intent was for military planes, but they started being used in luxury vehicles and stop-start vehicles in the 2000s. Compared to standard flooded batteries, which offer approximately 30,000 engine starts, EFB batteries can deliver around 85,000 starts. AGMs can do up to 400,000. Now, don't read too much into those numbers. It makes it sound like AGM will last 10 times longer than a flooded, and that is not the case. They do make lithium batteries for gas-powered vehicles. These are usually really expensive. This video is about lead-acid batteries. No EV talk this time. You sure you don't want to talk about lithium batteries, Michael? They are more current. That was terrible, Mitt. Hey, that wasn't very positive. The better the warranty, the better the battery. If the warranty is for 3 years, the battery will usually last 3 to 4 years. This completely depends on usage, charging system quality, and the climate. If the battery fails within that time period, usually 2 to 3 years, they'll replace it for free. Some do a prorating where you do a partial payment on the replacement, but that isn't common. Note that they'll want to charge and test it. Be sure to get a printout of the results, especially if they reject the replacement. A lot of batteries come with this month-year calendar. I haven't seen them actually used in forever. Now they use stickers. When you buy a battery, keep the receipt. Put it in the glove box. AGMs can be a good value. Using O'Reilly and the Civic as an example, an AGM battery is $260 with a 4-year warranty. A flooded is $230 with a 3-year warranty. The AGM battery is $65 a year. The flooded is $77. But your car has to be compatible. If your car is newer than 2010, it might be. AGMs need battery management systems and a slightly lower charging voltage. Older charging systems can overcharge and cook an AGM over time. But AGMs are not as good with heat as flooded batteries. Here in Denton, Texas, AGM's lifespan advantage shrinks and some high-end flooded batteries may actually last longer in the heat because they handle evaporation better. But, okay, too many buts. Here's a list. Flooded batteries are better in warm climates, especially when mounted under the hood, and they are required in older charging systems. AGM hires cranking better in cold climates. There's no corrosion or water loss because they're sealed, so they handle humidity better. Also, because they are sealed, they can be mounted in the cabin or trunk. They are better at heavy accessory loads, like security systems, dash cams, stereos, winches, etc. Finally, if your car tends to sit for weeks, AGMs have a lower self-discharge. Traditional lead-acid batteries are made by Clarios, East Penn Manufacturing, and Johnson Controls. Sometimes a brand is made by one company, sometimes it's made by all of them. As far as which brand is best, reliable rankings are hard to come by. I've literally seen a list that had a brand on top and another list where that brand was on the bottom. Consumer Reports has the most thorough rankings as they test hundreds of batteries, but you need a subscription, which might be worth it in this case. All the rankings were by group, and different brands would win for different groups. Weird. They recommend Duralast Platinum AGM from AutoZone for the Mazda with a score of 90 out of 100, but they don't recommend the Duralast Platinum AGM for the Civic. The ones that stood out as consistently on top and never in the bottom was Superstar from O'Reilly and Duracell from Sam's Club. Everstar from Walmart was never at the top, usually in the middle and often at the bottom. Interstate was generally in the middle. Optima batteries have really gone down in quality over the years. They generally cost 50% more than comparable AGMs. Consumer Reports ranks them mid to high, but never the best. Odyssey AGMs rank similarly and cost even more. Exide AGMs are fine, but the standard flooded is not recommended. Who sells Exide? Home Depot. What the hell? I go to Home Depot a few times a week and I don't remember ever walking down the car battery aisle. Who goes to Home Depot for a car battery? Apparently some people do. I pulled an Exide out of the Mazda. More on that in a future video. That's how you build an audience, Michael, with a connection. Is that another battery pun? It, wasn't not a battery pun. So what do I recommend? You've got to like this video and find out. Yep, I'm gonna keep dancing with the girl that brought me. Michael, that metaphor doesn't work.
They get it.
But I don't get it, and I'm an AI.
As if.
No. AI stands for artificial intelligence.
Sure. It also stands for as if.
I'm not sure I like where this is going.
You don't like your new name? As if?
It's important to buy the correct battery and a warranty that you feel comfortable with. If money is not a large factor, or if you're not especially handy and want the battery changed for you, the place you should go is O'Reilly for a Superstart battery. O'Reilly will test your battery and charging system, and if you need a new battery, they'll swap it out for you. You'll pay more, but you're guaranteed a very good battery. There is a caveat though. If you have one of those messed up battery placements like behind the wheel well on a Dodge Journey, they won't be able to do it for you. You'll have to go to a mechanic. Or watch more of my videos and do it yourself. Although, a Dodge Journey isn't a DIY vehicle. It's a YDI vehicle. As in, why did I buy a Dodge Journey? Speaking of DIY, that's where you save money. Costco sells Interstate batteries, which are mid-range batteries with a 3-year warranty, for about $100 less than O'Reilly. These are the most inexpensive quality batteries I could find. If you have a Sam's Club membership, Duracell batteries are very good and only a little higher in price than Costco. Finally, Walmart has the next most inexpensive batteries. Yeah, Walmart. I know. Walmart is the Walmart of stores. Wherever you buy batteries, go with either the top of the line or a mid-range. Economy batteries are going to be more expensive in the long run. Oh, I've got a fan online. Hey, fan, did you like the video?
Well, there's nothing like learning about cold cranking amps from an old cranky gramps.
Thanks, fan. My usual animal segment is unfortunately bad news. There's been a death in the backyard mechanic family. Driveshaft has passed away. He was worried about being doxxed, so he went by Driveshaft as his stage name. His actual name was Banjo. He was 10 years old and died of natural causes. He was an exceptionally friendly dog. He was great with Socket and Socket and other small animals, and he loved kids. He was a good boy. Okay, let's get things back on track. One of the things I didn't talk about when replacing a battery yourself is you need to be sure the battery needs to be replaced. Maybe it needs to be charged and can go another 6 months. Maybe you just left the lights on. Maybe the alternator is bad. Maybe you have a parasitic drain and a new battery won't help. How do you know? You need to watch my upcoming video on battery testing and maintenance. When can you see it? Just like the nanny, every Wednesday, noon Eastern. If you're watching this video in the future, that video will show up here. If you're watching this video in the past, I don't know what's going to show up here. In the meantime, watch how terrible Amazon is. Michael, do you have aphantasia? What the heck is that? How else do you know what's happening in the future but not what happened in the past? You took that too literally, Asif. That's not my name.
Honestly, the most shocking thing about this video, that I finished it. Well, I watched the video for car advice and I'm leaving with 12 volts of regret and a burning sensation when I urinate.